Thank you very much. I will try to stick about the topics of this afternoon and not to open so much the discussion. As a cognitive scientist, I could say for sure these things. Imagine a world without any, this is a way to answer in some sense to what Luca De Biase asked. Is technology the limit of what is socially possible? Imagine as a thought experiment, a situation in which there is no technology at all. A situation in which we are hunter and gatherer. We just people, we live in little groups of 40 persons, we go, we hunt, and we collect fruits and so on. In that case, in a situation as this one, what is primary about the topics of this afternoon? We could say that the language, the communication that we use in order to make promises, obligations, and rule that has not to be broken inside our community is the primary use of communications. The use of language for a description of something is not very relevant as a tool for defining what is the social object between us, money even if money comes after in the history of evolution. Another thing that we know for sure about these topics is that the evolution of technology has nothing to do with the evolution of the brain. In order to change the brain, you need at least 20,000 years. So it's very low. So the brain that we have now as the hardware of our mind is a brain that was developed many, many thousands of years ago, exactly when we were hunter and gatherer. Instead, the external brain that we have is a prosthesis. The external brain which is done, which is realized, which is possible through a smartphone, to a computer, to all these technological devices, tools that we have, has a very short history. So we have to interact with a very old mind, in which the evolution takes thousands of years, with something that is very recent. This is interesting, because if we run experiments in order to test whether our natural mind, that one that is supported by the brain, for example, connected to the topic of a joint commitment that Professor Gilbert spoke this afternoon. If we take the same logical operation, for example, negation, something, falsify a condition, look for potential example, counterfactual, in order to a rule, we are very different, we are very good, is whether the counterexample that we have to find is something that was the result to broke a rule. If to falsify something or to understand the counterfactual world is something which is matching the look for cheater, to find someone who is cheating in such a rule, we are very good. Instead, and that you can demonstrate with experiments on, I will not go into the details. Instead, if the same operation has to be done about something that is not to break a rule, we are very poor. We make error, it's very difficult, we run off the limit of our working memory that we have in order to do this operation. So it's very deep in our brain, this distinction between something that if you break, you, in some sense, you give you break the convention that there is inside the community. You make something that is prohibited by law. You take an advantage and you are cheating all the other. So you take a benefit without paying the cost to the community. In that case, all this type of situation is very different, and we are very well made for this type of operation. So in some sense, this distinction between the language as a tool for social interaction and the language as a description is something very wider, very old in our brain. And today, we find the difference in experiments. When we build an external mind that has to interact with our mind as this one, there are some operations that are matching very well between our mind and the external world. For example, memory. There was a paper 20 days ago in Science about the fact that people that start very young to use these tools, they have a different strategy to memorize things. Why? Because they have the documents inside this machine external to the mind, so they don't need to memorize these things. In that case, the strategy of memory are deeply affected by the possibility to have a technological device. Instead, other operation as logical transformation and so on, these are not so deeply affected because the constraints of our mind are very, very strong. And this type of constraints give the idea, as I told before, that this notion of a joint commitment of social objects is very, very old inside the way of life in which the first men, hunter and gatherer, live. So it is interesting because you have, even in the experiments on neuroimaging, in which you try to find the correlation between our software and our hardware, which is the brain, you find this distinction because different parts of the brain are processing this different type of tasks. So the contribution that we can have from our point of view of cognitive science is this distinction that we find in discussing the rules, the obligation, the rights, so on, is very deeply encoded and very old in our brain. There is also, very often today, we mention this in our book Neuromania, was translated by Oxford. There is always this question that even the newspaper likes, whether to use this machine change our mind. It is an obvious or a false question. Because it is evident that to use the machine after industrial revolution for centuries has nothing to do with the change of the brain, because in order to change the brain you need a thousand of years. Instead, it very deeply affected the way in which we use the strategy possible for memorize and so on. So there is a big change in the strategy of interaction with the machine. There is not a big change inside the brain of the person, because that you need a lot more time, as I pointed before, in order to change the brain. This is a complicated question, because when you have an archive, you put something external to your mind. Can happen a similar mechanism that applies to our natural mind. When we forget something, it's not that we discovered in the last century that was the forgetting was not something as the philosopher thought, that you write something on the sand and after it comes the water of the sea and this trace is canceled. Nothing in our brain is canceled. What is canceled is the way in which to reach this information. And you have many data in order to demonstrate. So you don't have the possibility to reach one information that is stored in your memory. I think that a similar phenomenon applies also to external memories, in which is very important the organization, the matching between the organization of your memory and the organization of the external memory, which is a technological memory. And of course, different communities, different people have a different way to handle, to cope with this interaction between the two memories. So to belong to a community is also to learn the way in which you organize the archives inside that community. And this is, in my opinion, this problem of organization is very, very relevant. Of course, in some sense, I think that between, even now, people have, I don't know whether it will change, because that could change with technological, the point that was raised also by Ferraris. We are more sure when something is written on something which is solid, on a piece of paper, or a piece of stone, or whatever you want, in comparison to the electronic memory that you have. So, in some sense, it is more relevant something that is written or something that you can touch, handle, and so on. Of course, the big difference is that as you change your information in your memory, you can change it more easily when the document is inside a technological memory, because here you can make some manipulation that you cannot make when these documents are inscripted in a piece of paper, a book of law, and so on, so on, so on. The big limit that we will have in developing technology in relation to the archives is that our working memory, the memory that we use in order to speak, in order to write, in order to make operation, has always a very limited storage capacity. We cannot put inside more than 5 to 7 information. You can learn to pack together some information. So it seems that your working memory is larger, but this in fact is not so. Just you learn to put together many operations, which is something that you learn when you became a professional in law, in many professions. But this is a big limit. Probably, if we could start a new man, we are a god, and we start a new brain 5 minutes ago, I don't think that we will build a brain as that one that we have as a human species. Because this is the result of the selection in which the only way to store information was inside your brain. So it was not so useful to have a very big working memory and to have a little long-term memory. Because if you lose information, where there are the enemies, where you find food and so on, you are lost. Instead now, of course, this is not possible, because as I told before, we need 20,000 years to change the memory. But as the evolution is always working, we could imagine that if the human species is gone with another 20,000 years, in very, very long term, it will be more useful to have a more powerful working memory to interact with our archives than the working memory that now we have, which is the same that had Aristotle, the same that had Raimondo Lullo, Leibniz, and so on. So this, in that sense, we are not built so well in order to interact with this memory. In fact, many of the problems, I will not go into the details, arise when we have these documents, the archive, and so on, by the fact that we have to interact with them with a very limited working memory. It is the amount of possible work that has a lot of increase. and attached to this possible world, they are secret world, they are world that you are accountable as a person, all the possibility, I will not repeat that Giorgio just mentioned. When you have many possible worlds, just a brief comment about your Auschwitz and the documents about the chemical. Don't forget the very old story of the dog in the night of Sherlock Holmes. Even the absence, the fact that it's lacking the documents is very relevant. Because once I study very well, I will not go into the details now because I've written the books, the case that 20 years ago a plane was entrapped in a fight in the skies near Palermo, and this plane went down. So the problem there was to imagine as Auschwitz. You win the war, you don't lose the war, but you want to cancel everything. It was very complicated because they have to cancel 11 different places in which the information was stored, because they have a radar in Poggio Ballone. They did so. So now you don't have, so it was disappeared. But the probability the probability that inside the American ship in Naples where there was the coffee
spilled,
the probability of Poggio Ballone, another intestine, you understand the problem. This probability was very low. So it was in my, what I tried to develop in that paper, it was the lack of information that was informative. So when all this world of different stories and so on that George Suel described, gone longer. In this different world, we have different way of life, different story about accountability, to be secret, not to be secret, and so on and so on. For example, to be secret about information, Tony Blair was a big information today.
Sure.
Similar to the Ustica problem in some sense. The traditional meanings of identity as a policy in France, they invented the way to make a registration of all the person through the fingerprints. Fingerprints are similar to tattoos because we have all different fingerprints. So this, one problem for identity today is to increase, for example, the British, they use the pupils. Every pupil is different from different person. So you have interaction between fingerprints, pupils, and so on. So this is what the Micheli say, the physical identity in the space. I am Paolo Negrezzi, I am not Giorgio Micheli. If we cross the border, imagine I am a terrorist, and he is not a terrorist, in the border between Arab and England, if you take a plane, is very relevant, this old idea of identity that was invented in one century ago by the French police. Completely different problem of identity, very interesting from the point of view of psychologists instead, is the identity of our story. In this night that we present in the first world presentation, the movie from movie maker, I think Swedish, which is taken from the history very well known of John le Carré, Tinker, Tailor, Soldier, Spy, which is a little poem for children,
spy story.
A spy story in which you have to make identity of the Tinker, Tailor, because one is a traitor. What the hero of the movie is old, what he does, of course it's not a problem of physical identity. This is a problem of identity of the story. What we know now, and it is something that one day we know very precisely, and perhaps we can implement also in the computer, is that the difference of identity between me and Giorgio is that if something new happens this night, something that is surprising for Giorgio and for me, we have to integrate this information in order to be consistent with all the information of our life, which is longer, might be a bit longer, but
almost.
This integration is a very, in order to have coherent knowledge, which is a more trivial, it is a problem also in artificial intelligence. It's very complicated in natural intelligence, this way in which we integrate something which is surprising for you, a new information that you have, is very personal from different person. In fact, even if more spy story, but what he does, the spy, people who are able to detect the spy, exactly that. He understands that this new situation created by him is something that, in order to be consistent with not a traitor, have to be done in a different way. So I think that our identity, not in the physical sense, but in the sense pointed by Giorgio, will be an identity of consistency of all the information that we have in our head. Because this is very, very personal. Because it is the way in which you condensate all the story of your life. Because you did in different, because the fingerprints are always the same. But the story of my life, even we are old friends, he could pretend to be me, better than Luca De Biase, because he knows a lot of things more than me. But there will be some pieces in which he will be not consistent with my story. And I will detect him as a spy, some will pretend to be myself.